Do you feel you have what it takes to edit a feature film or the next big streaming series? Beyond technical skills, editing large complex projects requires a well-organized process. Today I want to give you a small glimpse into how I use color labels to stay organized. I've edited a couple of very large projects, including feature-length documentaries and a 3-hour streaming show. I quickly learned that what separates editors is not just their technical skills, but their ability to create an organizational process. You may have the technical skills to edit the next Spielberg film, but if you can't organize your projects in a way that makes sense, you will quickly be unable to keep your head above water, drowning in the massive amount of clips, timelines, scenes, and revisions. For example, the last feature documentary I was hired to edit was a biographical documentary that was shot over a 5-year span. Just for the main character, there were 12 different interviews totaling over 9 hours of content. So it was critical to have an organizational plan from the very beginning. Using color labels can help you quickly identify different content in your project. Often with such projects, the director or the producer, they have a good vision of the story they want to tell, but they don't necessarily know exactly which clip or what soundbite go in what order. They don't come into the edit suite with perfect timecode notes for me to follow. I was delivered all the raw footage and then it was like, okay, let's get to work. How do we make this happen? So I just use a technique I often use on different kind of projects, and I hope you can find some good piece of information that you can implement in your projects. I put all the interviews on one long timeline and would listen and cut each answer and then place a colored label on each clip based on topics. Now we're not cutting anything yet. All we're trying to do is identify topics. So for example, if the person is talking about work, let's right-click on that clip and assign the color blue. When they're talking about their family, let's make those clips green. So after going over all 12 interviews, we ended up with hundreds of clips with a bunch of different colors. But it made it possible to visually identify where the person talked about a specific topic of our story. I believe we were able to identify 8 or 9 different topics. I then created a timeline for each color and gathered all the clips of that particular color. So now we have 9 timelines with every clips on it about that particular topic. So a timeline with all the blue clips, a timeline with all the pink clips, and I will assign the matching color to the timeline. So in Premiere, I can right-click on the timeline and assign it a colored label. In DaVinci, it's the same process. You can right-click on a timeline and give it a clip color. That made it possible to create a basic outline of the story. We could see the different main topics and start editing each individually. So if one of those is the person's childhood, for example, instead of looking at 10 hours of content to find where the person talks about their childhood, we're now working with, let's say, an hour of clips around the topic of their childhood. So it's a lot more digestible. We can tackle each topic one at a time, removing repetitive statements, identifying the better takes, and start building. I then embedded each of those timelines into a master timeline. So if I embed the blue timeline on my master, that timeline or sequence will show as blue in the master timeline, making it very easy to identify. By using embedded timeline, the master timeline is now simplified, and it's easy for the client to visually see the story. Each section is colored and we can start moving blocks around. Maybe the childhood is not the first section of our documentary. Maybe we can start with the yellow block or move the blue block to the end and move the pink block between the green and the purple. Using embedded timeline is a big advantage. I can easily move a section without having to grab hundreds of clips. I can just move the block. That's really when the story comes alive, when you're able to rearrange the order quickly and listen to different versions of how you want to tell the story. This was a 4-month long edit with a total of about 350 hours in the editing suite. Using those colors made it possible to stay organized until completion. Thank you for watching this video until the end. As a token of my appreciation, I'd like to offer you my free camera setting cheat sheet. Just follow the link below to download the free cheat sheet. Thanks again and happy filming.